All right, here we have Epson 1430, Epson Artisan 1430, and the print head is quite clogged, as you can see on the dark blue. This is an old Epson 1430. I've had it several years, and I use it every day. And so it has the type of clog in the print head where doing the cleanings doesn't seem to work well. And so that's where this comes in. I'll put a link in the description below where you can buy this kit. This comes with gloves as well, but I'm not going to use those for this video. But you can buy this on eBay. It's fairly inexpensive, and this is enough solution to do several cleanings. So the first thing that you want to do is push the ink button on your printer. And what that will do is it will allow you to access the ink cartridges. Now, I have an Epson continuous ink system on here, but this works for either way. I also have a video on how to use or install the continuous ink system. So once the carriage is ready for you to take out the ink, I'm going to go ahead and reach in the back and unplug the printer. Now that it's unplugged, I can move the carriage around however I want. So, like I said, we have the cyan, or the dark cyan ink cartridge that the nozzle is clogged, or the print head where that is clogged. So we're going to clean that out. And so we just take that out. So because these are all connected, because it's a continuous ink system, I'll just disconnect it. But if it's just one nozzle, you can take out that one cartridge if you don't have this system. So once I get this off, okay, I'm going to just kind of push it under here so I can set it aside and work freely with the nozzles here. So let me move this so you can see better. Okay, all right, so here we have the nozzles. The one on the right is the cyan. And if you're having clogging issues, you can spend a lot of money trying to use the cleaning printhead option on the software. So we'll be using this here. I'm going to just fill up this syringe. It's got a rubber tube that fits right over the nozzle. Okay, so now it's full of the solution. And we will fit it directly onto the nozzle. Kind of just pushes down on it. Okay, and you can see that the ink, if it comes off and this trough here gets kind of wet, that's okay, don't worry. But what we want to do is put some paper underneath it, and what that will do is catch it. There's these pads here. Let me move this here. So there's these pads that soak up the ink as you're printing. Once those soak up fully, then the printer expires, believe it or not. It's not cost effective for them to try and sell replacement pads for whatever reason, but there's a workaround for that also. I'll do a video on that where you can get the waste tank if you have that problem. Anyway, so what I'm gonna do is put a piece of paper down there to catch all of the ink as we push it through the system. I'm just going to cut about of a third of a sheet here. And I'm going to place it down in the bed. And I'm going to move the printer carriage back over it, just like that. So it's kind of coming out on both sides. And then what I'm going to do is just slowly press some of this fluid into, and you can hear it sometimes if you listen. So first it's going to be pushing the ink down. And so once you push, I pushed maybe, let's see, maybe 1 milliliter down there now. Kind of almost makes a hissing sound. If you push too hard, the hose will actually pop off, and then you'll spray this all over. Just dry it up if you do, but you don't need to add too much pressure. So now we're coming down to about 2 milliliters. And so what I'm going to do is I'm going to let this sit for 5 to 10 minutes, push it down a little more. And what you should notice, let's go ahead and move this over so you can see. There we go. It's purging out. I've got some on my fingers. This is why I use the gloves that come with the... Sometimes I've had clogs so bad on several of the nozzles that I ran the cleaning system and then it took about a day for it to cycle all the way through. This is definitely the way to go. Saves you money, so you're not using the ink as your purging fluid. And it's not a harsh cleaner. You can get it on your hands, but it does the job in breaking up any dry and clogged ink. So it doesn't smell or anything. So what we'll do is we'll just wait a few minutes, purge it through. You might need to put another piece of paper down as it soaks up if it's too soggy. And so just do this in a clean workspace. But we'll go ahead and wait just a little bit and we'll come back. Okay, it's been a while, so I'm just gonna push a few more milliliters through the nozzle, just kind of wash it out. Go ahead and move it over and see. So I'm going to go ahead and switch to a new piece of paper. Garbage can on standby just in case you drip this. And if you have multiple nozzles that are clogged, then you just go through and do each nozzle. See how that looks. Okay, it's a lot clearer. You can run this until it just comes out totally clear. But usually, I haven't had to do that. Okay. All right. Now, what's happening is it's kind of bleeding into. If you looked at the bottom of the where the print head actually is, it's a flat plate with tiny holes in it and all of the ink pushes through it, so you'll notice that it's kind of discolored. Like maybe you see some magenta in there at first, but this should do the trick. We'll go ahead and plug it back in, print a pattern. I'll just go ahead and sop up the anything that kind of went down below. And the next thing you print, if you print right away, so right now I'm sopping up even some of the ink that was just on this waste pad underneath. So not all of this is from the printhead solution. But when you print next, it'll take a few cycles for it to start printing ink. 100%. You might notice that the print quality doesn't look good for the, you know, if you print a full page, it shouldn't take a full page to look good, but go ahead and wire this back up. Alright, so I just put my ink cartridges back in, close this, and another thing I've found, because I use this printer pretty much every single day except Sunday. I don't work on Sunday, and then light use on Saturday. So guaranteed every time on this one, I have three of this exact model, and all of this works on the Epson Artisan 1400. But I've noticed that after that period of time, this specific printer always has a clogged print head. And sometimes I can print a few and then it clogs, sometimes right off the bat. And so, it, believe it or not, closing the paper lid and closing the tray prevents airflow, which dries it out. I've noticed that that seems to work well to keep your printhead from drying out or the nozzles from drying. It's just a little trick, but let's go ahead and plug in, power it on. We'll get a piece of paper and we will run a couple prints and see how it looks. Okay, so once you run it through a couple cleanings, that will purge out the solution from the nozzles and bring the ink back in. And you may see some splotching or something on the sides of your pages as it feeds through. And so we'll go ahead and print a test page. So this is two cleanings through the software just to bring that ink back in. And it should look good. Okay, so here we have it. Almost 100%. So we got a empty line there, kind of a broken line there, but that is infinitely better. All the other print heads look good, all the other nozzles. So that is how you print or clean your print heads. It's a very simple process. Takes about 20 minutes tops. And again, I'll put a link of where you can get this stuff in the description below. And as you can see, we barely used any of it. We used 10 milliliters and it's 125 milliliters. So we got easily 11 cleanings, maybe more. You don't always have to use a full syringe, but I just like to because it's not that much. So anyway, that's how you do it. You can save your printer if it's been sitting around and it's not printing. Chances are you need this stuff. So thanks for watching. Let me know if you have any questions in this section below. Have a great day.